Hi guys, welcome to my presentation, and my name is Josh, a Chinese management traveling student. This is my webinar in our business 2.3.0 business law. So I'm very happy to talk something about our laws and air pollution. Okay, the first thing you may confuse is my mask, because I wear like a dog tag. Because I'm in Beijing, the air pollution is very heavy. Sometimes you may cannot see the sun in the sky, so that's why a lot of people wear a mask to reduce the harm. So let's remove it and talk about our presentation. As you say, our presentation is talk about air pollution and the laws. I try to make my presentation very brilliant, and I make a very good PowerPoint after that. The first part is what is air pollution, and the history about the air pollution and the laws in America. Then the other situation in other countries and the laws in China. I want to try to make complex the different area. So what is air pollution? Air pollution occurs when harmful substances including particulates and biology molecules are introduced into Earth's atmosphere. It may cause disease, allergies, or death in humans. It may also cause harm to other living organisms, such as animals and food crops, and it may damage the nature or build environment. Human activity and nature processes are both generate air pollution. And this is the procedure how the air pollution affect us. So the first thing is the discharging the air pollution, then it's going to the air, then third one is going that with the raining or the snowing, then it's going to the ground with the so the health effect. Air pollution is a significant risk factor for a number of fluid-related disease and health conditions, including respiratory infections, heart disease, COPD, stroke, and lung cancer. The health effects caused by the air pollution may include difficulty in breathing, coughing, asthma, and loss of any other disease. So the most common results of air pollution include the particular ozone, oxygen oxide, and carbon dioxide. So the second part is about the history of air pollution. Air pollution, particularly in cities, is certainly not a new problem. Back in the Middle Ages, the use of coal in cities such as London was beginning to escalate. The problem of poor urban air quality even as early as the end of the 16th century are well documented. The first part is in the UK Industrial Revolution during the 18th and 19th centuries was based on the use of coal. The industry often located in towns and cities and together with the burning of the coal, the home of the most peaked urban air pollution level often reached very high level. So the second part is during the first part of the 20th century, tighter industrial control lead to the reducing smoke pollution in urban area. In 1922, smoke, as mentioned, was aimed at reducing the air pollution. Third part is the Great London Smoke of 1962. This one is very famous because a lot of people died from it. And the first part is following the Clean Air Act, air quality improvement continued throughout in 1990s. Those are the very famous air pollution things. And the fifth part is during the 1980s number of the populations of the urban area. This pattern, I think, is in the Los Angeles and has a lot of success. And this pattern is 1995, very near to us. This is a map about our United States. You can take a look at it. Of the first part is in California and in the east part of America. And we can see our state is evolving by something. So the third part is about the law. This part is about the law. So we can talk all the law about the air pollution, which is Clean Air Act. The Clean Air Act is the United States federal law designed to control air pollution on nation level. It's one of the United's first and most important influential molten environment laws and one of the most comprehensive air quality laws in the world, as with many other major U.S. federal environment agencies administered by the U.S. Environment Protection Agency. So I make a timeline for the Clean Air Act. You can take a look at it. The very beginning is 1995, and the ending, it's not ending, but it's in some time, 1977. The first part was in 1995, the Air Pollution Control Act. The Air Pollution Control Act of 1965 enhanced by Congress to address the nation's environment problem of air pollution on 1995, July 14th was an act to provide research and technical assistance related to air pollution control. The act left cities particularly in charge of the prevention and control of clean air at the source. The act declared air pollution was a danger to public health and welfare. But preserve the primary responsibility and right of state and local government in control air pollution. Second one is 1965 Motor Vehicle Air Pollution Control Act. It's a 95 amendment to the U.S. Air Act of 1967. The amendment said the first federal vehicle in nation started to begin with the 1962 model. So the third one is in 1967. The Clean Air Act is a comprehensive federal law that regulates all sorts of emissions. And the 1977 amendment said more about it to make people about it. The 1990 amendment to the AAA in large part was intended to meet the unaddressing or superficially addressed problems such as frequent ground level vehicle contact. So the laws in 1970 did something called the OST Act. Because of this central role, main senator immediately mostly played in very important role. So the last part is as mentioned, 1977, the Clean Air as mentioned of 1977 required prevention, significant determination of air quality to address the changing methods and as a requirement for the non-sentient area. So if you want to know more details about the Air Clean Act, you can use this website to look more details. So the first part, the situation in other countries. A lot of countries make the laws about the air to protect the air situation. And a lot of countries make international laws. First one is Convention in England Rent in Geneva. Second one is Framework Convention on Climate Change, New York. Third one is Global Dashi Proof Sound International Ash Strategy, Vancouver. First one is Canada Air Quality Agreement in 1986. Fifth one is the Vienna Convention for the Protection of the Urban Lawyer. And the fifth part is laws in China. In China, the legal framework has different left and right measures. National People Congress has the main role of producing laws. Each Congress comes to the State Council and the ministries to formulate policies. The legislation of China is that usually guide the political and local government. The first law is the Environment Protection Law. The second law is Air Pollution Prevention and Control Law. The third one is the Environmental Impact Assessment Law. The third one is Law on Promoting Clean Production. The fourth is the Emerging Convention Law. So here's my reference, and welcome to my presentation. I hope you like it. Thank you so much.